speaker, Ambassador Virendra Gupta. Ambassador Gupta, are you around?
Yes. Yeah, yes. I'm here.
Can you hear me? Yeah. So, briefly, let me just introduce him. He, Ambassador Virendra Gupta, served as India's High Commissioner to Tanzania, Trinidad and Tobago, South Africa, and several other Caribbean countries. He served as Deputy Director General of India's largest security studies think tank, IDSA, and Director General, ICCR. The full bio, as I told you, would be circulated and has already been circulated. So I move on now to asking him a couple of questions. Essentially, Ambassador Gupta, enough has been said, and we have such a fantastic panel with great ideas coming in. You could focus primarily on a kind of an action-oriented agenda. You've written about the India-Africa Forum Summit process. Then we talk about the fourth summit. Ideally, if there was no, the pandemic had not happened, we would be probably having this summit towards the end of the year, but it will happen sooner or later within the span of a year at the moment. How do you look at this evolving agenda? What are your wish lists? Where do you see the two regions going together? Thank you.
Well, thank you, Manish. Thank you, first of all, for giving me an opportunity to share a stage with very important, distinguished people, and providing me an opportunity to see some of my very old friends, Anil Suklal, Rajan Harshe, Rahul, so many different people, and I'm so happy to be here. I would touch upon just a few points because a lot has been said already. We are at the closing, we are at the end of this very important seminar. Happy Africa Day, first of all. I'd like to touch upon what Anil had briefly referred to, the people-to-people connect. I think when you look at India-Africa, there are so many characteristics, so many defining things, which I will not go into. But one of the most compelling things which distinguishes India-Africa relations is people-to-people, strong people-to-people connect. Now, it seems to me, unfortunately, that at the present time, our government does not seem to be paying adequate attention to strengthening these people-to-people relationship. And it's been largely left to, people themselves. We have a strong diaspora. We have had traditional and historic connect. But I think, at the level of academics, for instance, the relationship has not remained as strong as it was. The interest in African studies in India is dwindling, which is very unfortunate. And I think all of the activities need funds. So my suggestion, first of all, is for the government, while the government-to-government relationship is very robust, I think we need to pay attention at the government level to strengthen people-to-people connect. And I think for that, you need to put money there. Now, there are many which ways it can be done, but I just wanted to leave the short point. And while we are at the people-to-people connect, I think I'm quite embarrassed, actually, quite frankly, to see occasional incidents of how we treat the Africans in India. I think that needs to stop completely. We need to be more conscious at the level of our common people about the strength of our relationship, about our historical connect. And I think there again, the government agencies have to do a lot more in terms of creating greater awareness. Now, Manish, you asked me about the way forward. How do we go forward on this India-Africa relationship? I know the fourth edition of the India-Africa Forum Summit should have been taking place this year. I don't know whether it will take place this year, but soon enough, it doesn't matter whether it will take place this year or whether it takes place early next year. I think what I'd like to say is that there are some the sectors, the areas that we need to focus on, particularly in the current times of difficulty. A lot of other speakers have reflected on it. I will not go into it. This mechanism, India-Africa, India-Pan-Africa mechanism, I think it's going very well, but we need to be conscious about the limitations of that. There are, capacity constraints, for instance. And I think it has been said even earlier that undue reliance, if we were to repose undue reliance on the Pan-Africa platform alone for delivery of our projects, very often there is criticism that we are not able to implement. We make very ambitious announcements, but we are not able to implement those projects. And to me, it seems that the reason primarily is that we depend too much on the Pan-African platforms. Now, if I were to look at South Africa, India has excellent relations with South Africa at the political level, at the economic level, at the people's level, our BRICS membership. And whenever you look at either the entire continent or individual countries, the question of China comes in. I think to my mind, that is an irrelevant question because it's a mug's game to begin to compare ourselves with China in trying to see what we can do with Africa. There is a lot we can do with Africa. We have our unique strengths. But I think what we have to understand, South Africa as a large country, as a powerful country in Africa, has unique role. It is the chair of the African Union. It has always played a very important role at the African continent, at the Pan-African level. But I think even more important than that, I would say, is South Africa's role at the regional level, at the Southern Africa level. South Africa has a unique role in Southern Africa, in SADC. And I think we are conscious of that, but I think we need to leverage that a little more than what we've been doing. And the same would apply to Nigeria. We have excellent relations with Nigeria, and Nigeria equally has an important role to play in West Africa. So what I'm trying to say, without taking too much time, is that we need to go beyond the Pan-African platform and begin to relook and look at how we can strengthen our instrumentalities, our cooperation with individual countries in Africa at bilateral level, and even more important, approach them at the regional level. And at that regional level, I think we are not doing enough in connecting with Africa at different regional levels. And I think in Africa, these regional configurations are extremely important. And that is where our relationship, our special relationship with South Africa, our special relationship with Nigeria will begin to play a very important role. Thanks, Manish.
Thank you.